Today, I want to talk to you about science. Just kidding. I want to talk to you about transitional and developmental coaching and the differences between the two. In the first 90 days by Michael Watkins, he examines these distinctions, and I want you to see how they relate directly to our leadership pipeline philosophy and framework. So let's take a look. Transitional coaching focuses on the bends in the pipeline. It's all about how someone transitions from one leadership level to the next. So it happens right here. It's very important to understand what the situation is. So as you coach this person, you want to help them assess their new role and assess that situation. What are the responsibilities? Who are the people involved? Once they've assessed the situation, they need an action plan in place. Help them create a strategy that builds momentum and manages their own personal responsibilities. Now let's take a look at the developmental coaching. If you follow leadership pipeline discussions, then you already know I advocate for developing people at all levels of the leadership pipeline by helping them walk through three phases at each level: learn, lead, and multiply. Now, developmental coaching focuses on these three elements to help prepare a leader for future transition. To coach this person, identify gaps in their core competency or role-specific responsibilities and create a developmental plan that addresses each of these areas. Now that you understand the differences between transitional and developmental coaching in your leadership pipeline, what are you going to do about it?